Build 'em. Build 'em. Build 'em. Build 'em. Build 'em. Complete 'em. Complete 'em.
Thank you. Build 'em.
Thank you.
Here we go, the probably my favorite new feature in the PC build is this farming and civilizing. We've gone through, God, Jack, we've gone through so many iterations.
At least three major iterations, yeah. But this is where the game really starts for me.
It really allows you to strategically organize your population into a far more efficient workforce. It also solves one of the problems that I'm sure you're frustrated with now, and that is the number of clicks you have to collect belief. Now, we have considered a whole host of things to help with that. We've considered birds flying out and picking up the belief for you. We've considered statues that allow you to auto-collect belief. But actually, the answer is in settlements. What you can do with settlements is group all your abodes together into one enormous village, town, and eventually even city. And that means you've only got one click to collect all your belief. So do this now. Really play around with it. Move the circle around to get as many abodes in. Try it out. Get a sample of it. See if you like the look. Think about how you're going to expand after that. This is where the real strategy is. I have seen many people, you know, with careful placement of settlements, really advance much further. My after this card is unlocked and the builder settlements afterwards, I find my world reduces down from about 50 abodes to about 10 abodes. And, you know, as many settlements as I can squeeze in. You'll also have to save up belief. This is well worth saving up for. Do everything you can to get belief. Do voyages, go on rock hunts, spend some of those gems. You want this feature now because the game really starts improving after this feature.
Take advantage of the old preview button as well with the settlements, because you can keep moving that ring around so subtly and get very different results with the kind of clumping of the houses as they build these like shanty towns, and you can get some really lovely creative stuff and continue to apply to it as well. And if you look at the abodes, we've kind of gone through a few different abode designs over the times, and some of them weren't too kind of complementary to the repetition of abodes and things, but now we've kind of gone with this nice blockish look, which really allows you to kind of clump all the houses together, and it gives us somewhere to go later on as well.
Thank you.
Build 'em.
Wood-built abodes. Now, this allows you to build bigger abodes on sand. It's a tough choice, this one. You're just at the stage where you're realizing the different types of stickers are not different advances for your people. Personally, I tend to leave this one for a little bit later because I want to save my green stickers up for the larger abodes on sand because I'm building settlements now. I really want those larger abodes to be grouped into my settlements. So my tip to you is don't unlock the wood-built card until you've got larger abodes, but it's very much up to your personal play. This is very useful if you're a sculptor. Now, I find myself being less of a sculptor at this stage of the game and a little bit more of a planner. I'm more tweaking things. I'm more placing down trees to buff my abodes. I'm doing a lot of voyages. So I don't tend to go for this card until I've got the right stickers. I definitely am not unlocking this card if it's a multi-pip sticker. If the sticker has got multiple resources on, don't burn a valuable resource on that. I would hold back on this until you unlock at least the third expansion shrine. And that's where, when you've unlocked the third expansion shrine, there's quite a lot of mountain sculpting to do. Because hidden inside some of the mountains are treasure temples. There's also a new way of getting gems as well. So I would be careful about unlocking this card.
I was going to say, I always kind of prematurely unlock this one because I'm always really excited just to move lots of land out of the way. But yeah, you're probably a bit more on the nail with the strategy there, waiting for a few more expansions. And the whole cliff sculpting thing is something we're going to continue to kind of improve as well.
Thank you. Complete them.
Thank you.